one of the best things about living the Florida life? Sitting back and enjoying a nice cold drink by the beach at a locally owned restaurant, one like Fincher's. I'm enjoying one of their very own craft beers right now. This is FLA IPA. And it's delicious. Here in Florida, we enjoy a lot of variety thanks to the growing craft beer craze. So what's the recipe for success? Let's find out.
Locally, it's just exploding, and it's exploded fast.
Florida is known for relaxation and indulgence, so it's somewhat of a surprise that until a few years ago, the Sunshine State was routinely written off as an afterthought by craft beer geeks. Only 57 breweries were reported in 2012, but that has changed.
I think it's catching up a little bit to the rest of the country, but people, I think, just naturally want to see something local.
There are now well over 200 craft breweries pouring flavorful beers in Florida, including Bonehook Brewing Company in Naples and Fort Myers Brewing Company in Lee County.
Fort Myers Brewing is, we were the first microbrewery in Lee County, and we, Rob and I, decided to build a place where we thought the community could come together and enjoy some craft beer and just have some fun, and it's exploded ever since.
In some ways, we are a little bit behind the curve for the market for the rest of the nation. In some ways, we're doing a lot of interesting things. We have beers called Florida Life, you know, these interesting tropical fruits added to our sour beers that not a lot of people, say, in the Midwest are doing, or on the West Coast are doing. I mean, they can, and they might, but not as much as I see just everywhere here in Florida.
Tourists are flocking to experience the Florida flavor and the camaraderie.
We have a lot of snowbirds, as we know, and they come from places where they're used to craft beer. And two, I think people really were craving flavor and also craving community. We've given people a place where they can just come and hang out.
All right, Josh, I'm belling up to the bar now. I would love to try some of your most popular beers. And you have a lot of beer on tap here. How many are those?
Yeah, there's 20.
20. Okay, is that typical? Is that normally what you carry?
Normally all 20.
Wow. Okay. Where do I start?
So I typically ask you, the new customer, what do you typically like to drink? Is it light beer? Is it IPAs?
I like to try different things, but I would say a lighter beer. I do like the IPAs.
I'd start you off with my best-selling, my flagship IPA, which is Dirty Dave's IPA.
Bonehook offers a huge variety and went through 1,300 barrels in just their first year of business.
I enjoy people coming in, even people that I know have been regulars here. I enjoy them coming in, getting flights of all the sampler sets of all the new stuff that we might have come out with.
Okay, Jen, so we are behind the bar, not a bad place to be, and my gosh, you have a lot of variety on tap. What should I try out first?
Well, our Gateway Gold is what we start. Generally, that's the first beer we offer to people. We have a Blood Orange Goza on tap right now, which is, it's got a Florida element to it. It's, you know, blood orange, and it's citrusy and a little sour, and something that's refreshing all day long.
There's something unique on tap for everyone at Florida Craft Breweries. From Ladies' Night at Bonehook, a cherry sour.
The color usually gets people interested because they'll see a pink beer down the bar.
Like, I'll have what she's having.
Do I want that?
To the chocolate peanut butter porter at Fort Myers Brewery.
You can taste both. It's almost like a Reese's cup. It's really good.
Yeah.
This is dangerously good.
What I like to see is them, you know, eyes closed, shaking their head because it's so good.
I think they walk away with knowing that we provide an excellent and consistent product.
All right, well, I can see why this is a lot of people's favorite places to be. So here's to living the Florida life.
Yes.
Cheers.